So conceptual and theoretical framework, when we talk of these, sometimes the researchers, particularly those who have started to just have started to do their research, parang they are having a difficulty or problems, particularly when they are preparing their conceptual framework. But you know, it's just very easy. Kasi in preparing your research paper or your research study, one of the requirements, of course, is to include the conceptual framework and theoretical framework. Okay, so you are required actually to write the conceptual framework of your study. Kaya nga, the first slide here would be after your review of related literature, you should be able to include after the synthesis under chapter 2, you should be able to include your theoretical framework and conceptual framework, because the conceptual framework actually steers the whole research activity. It will guide you. You would be able to know what will be done for your research. Kasi it serves as a map that will guide you towards realizing your objectives. You would be able to identify the data or gather the data considering the concept or the conceptual framework that you have included. So therefore, when we talk of conceptual framework, we're actually talking about the theoretical framework provides a general representation of relationship between things in a broader context, particularly considering the phenomenon that you have identified for your research. While when we talk of conceptual framework, we are actually talking about the specific research direction of your research, or the conceptual framework represents you, no, your researcher's synthesis of the literature on how to explain a particular phenomenon or event or concern that you have identified. Kasi the conceptual framework maps out the actions required, and it will give you the things that should be done. In a nutshell, when we talk of theoretical framework, we are actually talking about theories yan. But when we talk of conceptual framework, we're actually talking about the concepts being included in your research and the visual representation of those concepts, the relationship of those concepts. So when we say concepts, we're actually talking also about the constructs, and we are actually talking about the variables. Yun lang naman yun. So do not be confused. When we talk of concepts, when we talk of constructs, those are just variables. Whether independent variable, dependent variable, intervening variables, or moderating variables. So kapag ka theory, theory talaga siya. And I'm asking you to include in your chapters 1, 2, 3, siguro 2 to 5 theories that you believe related to your research, relevant to your research. Then eventually, you'll identify that one single theory, one to two theories for your proposal defense. Kasi eventually, baka the other theories you have identified are not really related to your research. Kaya the panelist would tell you to revise or to remove. Kaya there should be a backup. So I mentioned when we talk about review of related literature, that while you are reading, you should be able to have a list of variables or concepts or constructs or theories while you are reading literature you believe related to your research. Then eventually, you choose which of those theories are really relevant to your research. Then identify 2 to 5, pwedeng 2, pwedeng 3, that you believe really related to your research. So what is the purpose of theoretical and conceptual framework? First is it's actually the foundation of the research, your research. And it describes theories or concepts used in the study. Kasi eventually, after identifying the theories, you will explain how those theories are related to your research. And you have to describe them. Describe the theories or the concepts used in the study, how they are related to each other, and how they are relevant to your research. And both the theoretical framework and conceptual framework provide structure and vision. Both of them guide the collection and analysis of data in order for you to achieve your goal, your research goal or your SOP. So you need to visualize where you are going, and the conceptual framework will tell you where you are going. Kasi it's a visual representation. Siguro you might be wondering, ano ba talagang difference between the paradigm and your conceptual framework? the paradigm is actually the visual representation. When we say conceptual framework, we are talking about the explanation of the paradigm and the paradigm itself. So it contains the paradigm and the explanation of how the variables included in your conceptual frameworks are related. So both of them, both the theoretical framework and conceptual framework, direct the development of the study, and it will guide you, particularly to the collection and analysis of the data in order for you to achieve your goal, your research goal. And remember, both the theoretical framework and conceptual frameworks are used to understand a research problem. So later on, we will talk about why. So in order for us to know more about theoretical framework, we should be able to know the definition of a theory. What is a theory? So I have identified three definitions and we'll discuss them, the important words, phrase, coined words that are included in the definition of the theory in order for us to know ano ba talaga ang theory. So as you can see here, I have the first and the second as presented. So the theories are, remember, are formulated in order for us to explain, predict, and understand phenomena or phenomenon, particularly the phenomenon that we have identified for our research. And in many cases, to challenge and extend existing knowledge within the limits of critical bounding assumptions. Remember that the theory can be outdated. That's why it can be updated. Siguro you are very familiar with the multiple intelligences, di ba? So it can be updated. So yung theory about our multiple intelligences, that's one theory that can be used, that can be used for your research if it is really related to your research. So as you can see here, a theory is a set of interrelated constructs. So when we say constructs, we are actually talking about concepts. Ano ba yung mga concepts na yan? Those are words, no? Those are the variables, whether it's independent or dependent variables. Okay? Because sometimes we really need to identify those concepts that will be included in our conceptual framework, but they are also variables. And eventually, in our conceptual framework, in the paradigm, yung visual representation, yung illustration, we would be including theory. Because one theory or a single theory sometimes ay not enough for the development of your conceptual framework. And a theory also is a supposition or a system of ideas intended to explain something, intended to explain how your research is related to that particular theory, especially one based on general principles, independent of the things to be explained. And a theory is an interrelated set of constructs. So laging nandiyan, interrelated set of constructs. Yung word interrelated is always there. Constructs, nandiyan pa rin. So a while ago, as you can see here, constructs, concepts, di ba? But in the third definition, we have here interrelated set of constructs, variables. So constructs are concepts, which are also the variables. So in order for you not to be confused, diba, yun yung mga words that we use in the title of our research. Then eventually, the concepts or variables included in our research title would not be enough because there are intervening variables that sometimes will affect the result of our research or will affect the dependent variable or the independent variable, mga ganun. So we'll talk about that. Or these are actually the constructs or the variables are formed into propositions or hypotheses. Kaya nga, we have the null hypothesis or the alternative hypothesis, okay, that specify the relationship among the variables. So that's according to Creswell. And so therefore, when we take a look at the theory as interrelated concepts, there are three things that should be considered. So now, let's us actually take a look at each one in detail. So pag propositions, we are actually talking about something offered for consideration or acceptance. That's our proposition, kasi we are trying to gather data, empirical data, for our research. No, it's your proposal. Kaya nga, it's a proposition. And then number two, a theory is a set of interrelated constructs. So the constructs are the concepts. So do not be confused. Pag sinabing constructs, concepts din yun and variables. Okay, so definitions and or propositions that present a systematic view of the phenomenon. By simply, you have to specify relationship among those variables. But the purpose is to explain and predict the phenomenon. Para you would be able to know what will happen next. Kasi you are predicting eh, that when you develop your conceptual framework based on the theory that you have identified, you would be able to predict what will happen. Parang, but it's just a prediction. So a theory explains, no, for number three, explains and predicts phenomena or phenomenon. So it does so by specifying which variables are related to another variable or to the variables that you have identified and how they are related. So as a researcher, you would be enabled, no, to predict from certain variables to other variables. So that's a theory. So what are the characteristics of a theory? No, it should be logical and coherent. When we say logical and coherent, we're actually talking about the reasonableness, no, of the theory that you have identified, whether it's really related to your research or relevant to your research or not. No, and it should be reasonable. You should be able to justify why you have chosen that as your theory related to your research. Kaya nga, theoretical framework, no? Parsimonious, no? It should be economical. And it should be based on empirical data. So, ano ba yung empirical data? It's actually information or the data that you have gathered, no? Information that you have acquired through experimentation and observation. And those empirical data are essential for the scientific process. So the data that you've gathered are called the empirical data. Okay? And it belongs to the domain where it applies. So it belongs to a particular discipline. Yun yung mga theory na yan. So if you are a mathematics teacher, ano ba yung mga theory that we are using? So the past, you go back to your field of specialization, kung guidance and counseling ka, kung leadership and management, meron yan. Kung education, focus mo education, psychology, humanities, social sciences. So there are so many theories. And you have to identify where it applies, yung particular theory that you have identified. Then it comprises concepts, themes, no? And principles and constructs. The concepts and principles will explain what is going on and why. Alam nyo yung mga themes na yan, yung mga concepts na yan, it can be developed. It's unfolding. When you review related literature, you would be able to see the themes, the concepts that are really related to your research. It should have clear definition of terms and variables within some defined boundary of conditions. Yung assumptions natin. Yung assumptions, yung defined boundary conditions. And clear description of the relationship of the variables. Remember that a theory is a set of interrelated concepts, as I have mentioned earlier. Interrelated concepts, yung definitions, assumptions, yung generalizations, that will systematically describe and explain regularities, not irregularities, in behavior in educational organizations. Kasi nga, we are in an academe. So therefore, the focus would be behavior in an educational organizations or institutions. So, hypotheses are derived from the theory. Diba, sinabi ko kanina. So it's very important that when you are writing your hypothesis, whether it's null hypothesis or hypothesis or alternative hypothesis, it should be derived from the theory in order for you to predict additional relationship among the concepts. Yan. It also includes assertions and predictions. Okay? Kasi assertions and predictions must be, remember, must be different from or it could be better. No? It could be better than those in existing theories. Kasi assertions and predictions are not set in concrete. Kasi it is always subject for revision and improvement kasi it's unfolding. As the theory is used to make sense of the phenomenon that you have identified for your research, yung concern mo, yung event, yung problem mo that you're encountering when you are teaching. So it's unfolding. So predictions here must be general enough to be applicable in several contexts. So again, it includes assertions and prediction. So kapag sinabing assertions and prediction, again, I would like to reiterate, different from and it could be better than those in existing theories and applicable and will result in predicted outcomes. Again, no, not set in concrete kasi it can be revised, it can be improved, it's unfolding. Then concepts naman and principles, it will explain what is going on in your research and why you are doing that research. And the concepts and principles that you should be including in your theoretical framework and our conceptual framework should be substantive enough in order for you to predict future events. So principles, when we talk of principles, we are talking of the generalizations with substantial empirical support. So yan ang yung principles. Let's take a look at these. Now, facts and observations, now it's through experimentations, the empirical data that we have gathered, and then the hypothesis or hypotheses, now, hypothesis in plural, yeah, hypothesis singular, it's actually our well-educated guess. No? Kasi hypotheses are derived from the theory in order for you to predict additional relations among the concepts. When the hypothesis received overwhelming empirical support or empirical data, meron na, the accepted hypothesis become principles. Yan, principles. So again, yung assumptions natin, di ba, I mentioned earlier, are generalizations if they specify the relationship among two or more concepts. Kapag ka-hypothesis na yan, generalization yan, but with limited empirical support. Kasi nga, you are still doing, it's just your hypothesis, eh? It's just your well-educated guess. Now, if it contains already substantial empirical support, then it will become principles. And then kapag generalization with overwhelming degree of empirical support more than the principle, it will become a law. Law na siya. A law is an observation, di ba? Kasi it's always from the observations that we had, the empirical data that we have gathered. Theory is the explanation of the observation. These are the things that we have observed and we were able to come up with our theory. So that's the explanation of the observation. So a theory therefore requires experimentation. And as mentioned earlier, it will become obsolete with time. It can be updated. It can be outdated na. It's unfolding. Depende yan how you are going to contextualize it. Kaya when you identify, make sure na it's updated, it can still be utilized, and it's relevant to your research. Remember, a theory also can be replaced by another theory. Now, yung theory na nabuo ninyo, nagawa ninyo, just in case you would like to do a qualitative research, a theory-building research, then there is a possibility that your theory is strong or weak. It always depends on the amount of evidence that you have gathered. So, ganun siya lagi. This is very important no, in when doing your research kasi most of the students, parang hindi nila alam, ano ba yung theory related to my research? Yun yung unang tanong lagi. Ano ba talagang kailangan ko gawin in order for me to identify that single theory which is really relevant to my research? So the suggestion is you read related literature. Then nasabi ko naman sa inyo, when do I stop reading related literature, including related literature in my paper, di ba? When you have already gathered a repetitive data, meron ka ng mga theories na list of theories, list of concepts, and then those concepts and theories talagang may repetition, so you stop. Then you would, if you were able to read talaga the literature, you would be able to know what will happen. You would be able to map your conceptual framework. So therefore, what is a theory? Diba? Theory therefore is a generalized systematic statement na logical siya, coherent, clear, parsimonious. Yung parsimonious yun yung economical na sinabi ko kanina. Abstractions, propositions, ideas, yung definitions, yung conception, yung constructs or variables. It could be themes, yung principles. Basta it's related to your research. Or it could also be explanation of prediction of phenomenon and based on empirical data. The claim should always be subject to testing or verification. And so ano ang theoretical framework? Therefore, essential for those who are engaged in applied research. No? Usually naman yan. Kasi nga, the applied research is actually a methodology used to solve specific or practical issue affecting an individual or group. Kasi di ba ang usa na ngayon, even in the Department of Education, yung applied research na talaga siya eh. Kasi you would be able to help your school if you would be doing applied research. Kasi you would be solving problems or practical issues in your school. So, theoretical framework also will serve as basis for your study. Yung blueprint mo pa rin yan, yung guide, yung when you are, for example, if you are traveling, it's like a travel plan. And it will serve as a focus of your study. Kapag ka na-identify mo na yung single or one theory, one to two theory na really related to your research, then that would be your focus. That will guide you how to do it. Then it refers to a single formal pre-establishment. Single, dapat isa lang talaga yan. Borrowed from another researcher, that could be. Kasi nga, sometimes the researchers, when they do theory building research or qualitative research, like grounded theory research, then they would be able to build a theory. And then that could be borrowed. That can be utilized also for your research. So how to identify theory, pwede yan sa books, encyclopedias, yung credible websites, pwede rin yan sa theory in research, yung completed thesis and dissertations, could also be by simply exploring theories being used in your course, di ba? My suggestion is this, yung tip ay is to keep a list of theories and take note on how and why they were used. When you are reading those theories, you take note, paano ba nila siya ginamit? And how did the researcher use that particular theory for his research? And then you have to identify and learn more about relevant theories you believe relevant to your research by investigating that particular theory. So when you investigate theory, of course, you need to read literature. You have to search literature, search your strategy, identify and learn about those theories that you have identified. Then consider theories from a variety of fields like yung psychology. Ano ba yung mga theory dyan na pwede? Like yung human development theory, cognitive theory, about personality theory, about motivation theory. So kapag ka sociology naman, it could be social change, di ba? Trace, no? Yung class, yung gender. Yan, sa sociology yan eh. Kapag ka business naman, it could be leadership and management theory. Kapag ka health, it could be patient care. Patient care. Yung well-being of the patient. And the environment as well, kapag ka health, diba? The environment. We have here yung ZPT and scaffolding. I know you are educator, alam nyo yung mga to kasi we've been using them. Si Maslow's Hierarchy of Needs. Si Albert Bandura. Si Albert Bandura. We are very familiar with Albert Bandura. Ito yung social cognitive theory, diba? Which started as, if you are familiar with it, no? The social cognitive theory started as the social learning theory, di ba, ni Albert Bandura. And it developed into a social cognitive theory siya. From SLT to SCT, social learning theory to social cognitive theory. This is a one of the examples na that the theory can be updated, diba? The theory can be replaced. Ano ba yung unique feature ng SCT, ng social cognitive theory? It's actually emphasizes on social influence yan eh. So it also emphasizes on external and internal social reinforcement. Di ba? Tinuro sa atin nung college tayo. And then constructive model. And there are so many theories. Sa constructive learning model naman, this is constructivism, you know? It's a theory, basically a theory based on observation and scientific study about how people learn. If you would want to know in your research how your students learn, then constructive learning model is relevant to your research, no? As a theory. Kasi nga, the constructive learning model tells us that students construct their own understanding and knowledge of the world through experiencing things. And after that, they would be reflecting on their experiences. So that's constructive learning model. And si Piaget, no, we are very familiar with Piaget, no? It's actually studying the cognitive development of children and adolescents. Diba? That contains four major stages, as you can see, yung sensory motor, pre-operational, concrete operational, and formal operational. Then ano pa? Ito, yung multiple intelligences. This was updated, diba? Kung dati 8 lang. So this is the original. I just would like to show you kasi pag in-update to, mas marami na ngayon ang multiple intelligences that we are considering, diba? Then, TPAC model. Itong TPAC, na-update na rin tong si TPAC model eh. Technological, yung pedagogical and content framework, the intersection of the three is the TPAC model. It's actually a framework for teachers' knowledge that will describe the complex role of the three bodies of knowledge, yung content, pedagogy and technology. Kaya nga minsan I don't believe naman na yung IQ lang ng teacher talaga ang kailangan, kagaya ng sinabi ng ibang professors diyan. For us, kaya may mga theory na yan eh. In order for you to become an effective teacher, dapat you have to consider yung content, yung pedagogy, yung technology. Kahit naman sobrang talino ka especially in this time of the pandemic, if you don't know how to use the technology, hindi ka pa rin magiging effective na teacher. So there are so many factors that should be considered if you want to become an effective teacher. Ano bang advantage? Theoretical framework. Internal and external validity. So remember that when we talk of internal and external validity, these are concepts that reflect whether or not the results of your research are trustworthy and meaningful. Kasi kapag ka internal validity, this will relate how well your research is conducted. Yung structure ba ng theoretical framework mo will make sure that it will lead to internal validity, and the external validity will relate to the applicableness, no? Whether the result of your research is applicable, particularly the findings, to the real world. So the theoretical framework, therefore, will make sure the generalizability of your results. Kaya nga, it ensures external validity if you have the theory. And if the theory that you have identified is really relevant to your research. Remember that you can have a study with good internal validity siya, but overall, it could be irrelevant to the real world, to the others. Although, meron naman tayong sampling technique that we are considering. Now, when we use the sampling technique, sampling technique properly, then it could be generalizable to the population. From the population, you have identified sample that will be part of your research. On the other hand, well, if your study is really relevant naman, but that does not have trustworthy results, kasi failed ang internal validity niya, then it will also affect the result of your research. So, theoretical framework is very important when doing research. Understand the variables in your study, lagi yon. Review the existing literature. Use the information from the literature in locating the best fit theory. So, una siguro, 5 theories muna, then hanapin mo yung best fit theory. Then, select that is one that is most relevant to your study. But don't forget to avoid a too general theory. Example, yung too general, behaviorism theory, psychoanalytic theory. So, you must be specific para you would be able to contextualize. You would be able to relate it to your research. Then, health belief model, yung TTM, yung SCT is a specific theory. And then the socio-ecological model would also be particularly for the environment, yung sinasabi ko kanina sa inyo, under yung patient care also, no, yung sa under health. Kapag ka theoretical framework na, be guided by the school's policy din. Don't forget yung school's policy in identifying theoretical framework. Kasi nga, there are some schools na that combined theoretical framework and conceptual framework. Meron namang schools na may theoretical framework, may conceptual framework. So it's just like us in FEU Roosevelt. May theoretical framework, may conceptual framework. And it is included after review of related literature. Yung iba naman, nasa chapter 1. So, but for us, under chapter 2, after the review of related literature, yung synthesis niya. Then, consider theories and concepts aligned with your paradigm and topic. And explain how those theories and or concepts are related to your research.